This budget represents the first budget to be considered by council since the 2018 civic election. And there have been many demands placed on this budget. Expectations remain high, but budgets are, at their core, about decision-making, about prioritization, and about making compromises. They also have to make assumptions. They have to forecast, and they often have to do this with imperfect information. The preliminary budgets being tabled today are no different. As many of you know, preparing this year's budget was complicated by ongoing uncertainty regarding provincial government funding support to the City of Winnipeg. I want to reiterate that I fully support the provincial government's efforts to eliminate its budget deficit. I support their quest to return their budget back to a balanced one, and in doing so, follow the city's lead. But I don't believe this should be achieved on the backs of Winnipeg property taxpayers. As such, the preliminary budgets being proposed today for public and council's consideration reflect a balanced, disciplined, and accountable response to the healthy amount of funding uncertainty that remains with respect to the level of provincial capital funding that will be provided to the City of Winnipeg in 2019 and beyond. As I said earlier, the process of budgeting requires that assumptions be made, often with imperfect information. And we've had to do precisely that in preparing this budget. Built into the city's preliminary 2019 budget is the expectation that capital funding from the province will be limited to meeting provincial cash flow commitments for existing capital projects such as the Waverley Underpass and Bus Rapid Transit. Capital funding in 2019 for regional and local roads specifically is expected to be limited to only those commitments made under the Accelerated Regional Roads Program. These limits on funding, together with the provincial decision to not fully fund capital commitments for roads in 2018, creates at least a $40 million hole. It means the regional and local road program in 2019 is budgeted to be $86.4 million. And this represents a significant decrease from previous years and the lowest regional and local road budget since 2014. I spoke earlier this week about options available to council to address this shortfall. Raise taxes, increase debt, reduce the number of capital projects. I believe the more responsible way to address the shortfall is to reduce the number of road projects rather than ask Winnipeg residents to pay what would be about a 7.1% property tax increase. I also believe a budget reduction is a better option over incurring significantly more long-term debt. Also, I believe it would be irresponsible to budget beyond 2019, that is to forecast, expecting the provincial government to share the City of Winnipeg's priority to fix our roads. So what does this mean? It means the five-year capital forecast for the city's regional and local roads program only reflects provincial capital support that has been committed under the Accelerated Regional Roads Program. This means the historic $976 million road renewal plan adopted by council in September of 2018 would be reduced by $175 million, totaling $801 million, rather than the $976 million over 6 years. It also means less investment in the pedestrian and cycling program in 2019 and beyond. Overall, this will mean fewer road, cycling, and pedestrian projects will be undertaken this year compared to last year. It also means fewer projects will be undertaken in future years. I think it's safe to say this is the city's new road reality. And I accept this reality, and I feel our preliminary capital budget and five-year capital forecast reflect that reality in a responsible and accountable way moving forward. So I want to highlight a few other items proposed in the preliminary budget. In total, the 2019 tax-supported budget proposes to spend a little over $1 billion. That's a lot of money. Almost half, or about 45%, or about $502 million, or about $500 million, is to support public safety, which includes police as well as fire and paramedic services. Keeping residents safe, it comes at an expense, but it remains a priority. In my time as mayor, the police budget has never been decreased. The police department is proposed to receive an increase in 2019 of 3.4%. The fire and paramedic department is proposed to receive an increase of 4.2%. There are also several important capital projects proposed for each department. I want to highlight that 2019 will be a transition year for the Winnipeg Police Board as well as the department. The existing Winnipeg Police Board's strategic plan, it covers the five-year period from 2015 to 2019. And this year marks the last year of that plan. Beginning later this year, the board will be working on and preparing a new five-year plan for 2020 to 2024. And I think it's safe to say the environment for policing has shifted since 2015, when the initial strategic plan was prepared. Some types of crime are on the upswing after previous years of decline. The meth crisis is being felt here as well as across the country. A brand new legal framework has been introduced regulating cannabis, requiring the police service to enforce aspects of the new legislation. This is a transition year for the board as well as the service. It will be an important year for them, and I believe the resources proposed this year reflect that importance. Some other notable budget items. The business tax is proposed to be reduced from 5.14% to 4.97%. And this represents almost a 13% decrease in the rate compared to 2014. It's also a further step towards its eventual elimination. Property taxes are limited to 2.33% increase and dedicated to addressing Winnipeg's infrastructure requirements. No new fees are proposed in the 2019 budget. No increase is proposed to residential water and sewer rates. No increase is proposed to the frontage levy rate. No increase is proposed to on-street parking rates. Transit fares are frozen at 2018 levels. A low-income bus pass is being recommended. Funding to purchase and install bus operator safety shields is being proposed. Protective vests for transit inspectors are also included. Renewal of the bus fleet continues with the proposed purchase of 34 new buses. Additional heated bus shelters are proposed in 2019, as well as funding to improve bus stop accessibility. The preliminary budgets proposed to take the next step in the electrification of the city's bus fleet. And for the first time in the city's history, the water and sewer dividend rate is proposed to decrease from 12 to 11%. More funding is being made available to community centers for upgrades and repairs. Significant capital investments are proposed this year and over the next 5 years to address combined sewer overflows. It's a significant increase. We're encouraging the public service to get smarter with significant operating and capital increases to support innovation and technological transformation. And additional funding is proposed to enhance, to support the enhanced winter maintenance strategy for active transportation. So this budget is preliminary. Over the next several weeks, it will be subject to public review and scrutiny in an open and transparent manner. It's also scheduled to be reviewed by each of the standing policy committees and the councillors who make up these committees. Ultimately, it is subject to council approval, who may not necessarily agree with what's being proposed. I do believe the preliminary budget reflects a balanced and accountable and disciplined financial blueprint for 2019. And I look forward to its further review over the number of weeks that will follow today.